Solid Works 2016.
Senior Application Engineer with EGS India. With utmost pride and immense pleasure, I would like to introduce you the all new SolidWorks 2016 announcement. SolidWorks 2016, the 24th release, has been built on the main theme, Make Great Design Happen. It is clear the meaning of great design is unique for all. It is also clear that great design has a common foundation, four pillars: design, validate, collaborate, and build. It is here that SolidWorks 2016 has focused hundreds of enhancements driven by our users and focused on what makes great design happens. To every user, every company, everyone in our worldwide community, let's see what SolidWorks 2016 has for you. SolidWorks 2016 shows a significant investment in the user experience and a solid foundation on which to build for future enhancements. We are constantly reminded the core of SolidWorks from sketching and modeling to assembly creation. It's the where our users spend much more their time. SolidWorks 2016 provides our customer with many more powerful enhancements that let them quickly create their details that were difficult or impossible before. Now let me start my enhancement with the user interface. So these are some of the enhancements in user interface. Like now we are having a new log command manager and new plan manipulator. Now let us have a look on SolidWorks. SolidWorks 2016 comes with many modern updates. Now it will support for high resolution 5K monitors. Now here icons and text scale up with the operating system preferences. Now we are having more control over the toolbar in command manager. In order to eliminate this accidental repositioning, now we are having an option to lock our command manager. So by having this option, it's very easy to lock our command manager. Another powerful enhancement in SolidWorks 2016 is the selection breadcrumbs. This will allow the user to increase their screen size. Still, we are having all the commands at our fingertips. For added convenience, by pressing D, we will get our selection breadcrumbs at our mouse location. Similarly, by selecting the feature, solid body, part, sub-assembly and assembly, we will directly get the command based upon our selection. For example, the feature like this lock, we can directly select our underlying sketch and we can easily edit them directly over here. Now in SolidWorks 2016, by pressing D, we will get our confirmation corner at our mouse location. This will reduce our design time. By pressing the D once again, directly we come out from the edit part mode and enter into the assembly. While looking at the feature manager, it's very clear that we can see both parent and child dependency. For SolidWorks 2016, it's only parent dependency. Now we are having both parent and child dependency. By having this new enhancement, we can easily find out the impact of modification on the underlying design. Another enhancement in SolidWorks 2016 is the plan manipulator. Helps for geometry alignment and also for section plan positioning. Now this large icon helps to find out which axis we are manipulating. Another enhancement in SolidWorks 2016 is the expandable selection list. By having this new enhancement, we can easily select our selection list at any time. At any time, we can auto-size this. Now, it's very easy to access our My SolidWorks search directly over here. So, these are just some of the enhancements in user interface which speed up our design by providing a convenient access to the commands when and where we need them. Now, let us move on to sketching. So we are having a lot of enhancement in our sketching, like we are having a new enhancement called InSight 2D, and also now we can reverse our sketch offset entities. Now let us have a deep dive into SolidWorks. SolidWorks 2016 has introduced many new enhancements. Now let us go and edit the main sketch of this wall body. For increased clarity, now we can hide our sketch dimension. Now the midpoint on sketch entities is dynamically highlighted for the application of the relation and dimension. Now it's very easy to carry out multiple operation on a single sketch entity. Now the contrast toolbar remained valid. Here I am adding the dimension. Once I made a horizontal relation. Now it's very easy to edit and modify our sketch dimension like Instant 3D. Now we are having a new option in our sketch called Instant 2D. By having this new enhancement, we can easily edit our sketch dimension. Now it's very easy to reverse over the sketch offset entity simply by double clicking the dimension. We can directly reverse the sketch offset entities.
You can see the changes made over to the model. Segment tool is a powerful tool for placing point to position holes on a shaft. So in SOLIDWORKS 2016, we introduced a new capability. While adding segment tool, then automatically the equal relation will add up. It will very helpful for placing holes, especially PCD. Even though if I am deleting any point, the equal relation will maintain, and also it's very easy to edit our segment point. Simply by edit segment point, by having edit segment point, we can increase or decrease our segment point. So all this enhancement under sketch will increase our productivity. It's mainly focused on our design, not on the software. Let us move on to part modeling. There are a lot of enhancements in our part modeling. Let us see one by one. First, the new thread profile. It is often required to create a thread profile for like 3D printing. For 3D printing, any shafts or holes, anything, it's often we need to model a physical thread. Creating the physical thread is a tedious one. Now SOLIDWORKS 2016 introduced a new enhancement called thread feature. By having this new enhancement, we can easily create our physical thread in our 3D model. Simply by specifying the thread location, and also defining the types and size over here, we can get our physical thread with a few steps. For non-standard thread, we can also easily create simply by editing the dia and pitch. Dia and the pitch directly over here. It is also very easy to create a multi-star thread. Like other features, we can pattern this new enhancement thread feature. The enhancement in thread profile does not end here. We can also customize our own thread profiles for our specific applications. Next, let us move on to sweep. We are having a lot of enhancement in our sweep command in SOLIDWORKS 2016. In SOLIDWORKS 2016, we no longer require to create a sketch plane and also the sketch profile for creating a soft circular profile. Now it's very easy, simply by specifying the dia and selecting the path, we can easily create our spot profile by having the new enhancement circular profile. It will also support for sketch and also the linear edges. Another enhancement in our sweep command. Now, from SOLIDWORKS 2016, we no longer require to create our profile at the end of our path. So we can specify the direction of our profile, direction 1, direction 2 or midplane, and also we can twist our profile. So all this enhancement in sweep command helpful to finish our model in a very easier manner. Now let us move on to pattern features. Creating and editing pattern is now very easier in SOLIDWORKS 2016. Now we can define that more input for our linear pattern. Planar face, cylindrical face can be defined as a direction input. The model like this hand grip without having a linear edge, it is often required to create an axis or anything in order to define the direction. Now we can easily give a direction input as a cylindrical face. Here I am specifying the cylindrical face as a direction input. By having this new enhancement, it's very easy to create our pattern on cylindrical faces. Variable pattern, which was introduced in our previous release, now we extend this enhancement. Now we can define the negative value for our variable pattern, and also we can get the data directly from the Excel. Productivity. First, the profile center mate. It has been added to the quick mate toolbar, and also we can lock the rotation for round selections. Also available is the symmetric mate when 3 selections are made, and also the width mate when 4 selections are made. In the previous release of SOLIDWORKS, we introduced the new capability to remove lost mate reference for the selected face. Now we extend this capability for an identical component. By using the capability select identical component, we can select the identical component in our assembly. Here is our clamping knob. I'm going to change the configuration of this knob. So I am getting the error in feature manager. This is because the face was replaced. Now I am going to edit any one of the mate. While editing any one of the mates, SOLIDWORKS will prompt her to repair all the missing mate references for our identical component. Really a time saver. Now it's very easy to copy multiple components in an assembly. Previously we can do only one component at a time. By simply Ctrl C, Ctrl V, we can do that. If you are having any mate exist between this component, that too will be get copied. Now it's very easy to select our desired configuration while inserting a new component. In SOLIDWORKS 2016, we are having a new enhancement, the configuration. By having this new enhancement at any time, we can select our desired configuration directly over here. Another enhancement in 2016 is, while adding any mate, the first selection will make the component transparent. This will be very helpful for defining our mate. Another much awaited enhancement in SOLIDWORKS 2016 is the component preview window. While adding any mate, we can preview our component. We have a new option, component preview window. We can select the component either here or directly from the separate window, our preview window. It's very easier for defining our mate in an easier manner. Now let us move on to the toolbox enhancement. In SOLIDWORKS 2016, we introduced the new enhancement in our toolbox, the favorite folder. You can add your toolbox component directly over here. So at any time, you can directly use your toolbox component directly from your favorite folder. And also now it's very easy to edit multiple toolbox component. And also, at any time, you can change your fastener type. So these are some of the enhancements in 2016, which helps to speed up our assembly process. So all the enhancement and the design is mainly focused on our design, not the software. Next, let us move on to the next category, collaborate. Under collaborate, the first one is a mate controller. Mate controller is a new enhancement in SOLIDWORKS 2016. By using mate controller, we can control specific mates and also we can save the position and also we can create animation based upon our saved position. Now let us have a look how it works on. What you do is, first you have to specify your mate. The supportive mate for mate controller is distance mate, angle mate, limit distance, limit angle, slot. So you have to specify your mate directly over here. And next you have to add your position. Here you can see some of the positions which I have added already. Now I am going to add some more positions. So these are the mate which I have specified in the box. You can change the value based upon your requirement. Once you change the value, you have to update your position. Now I'm going to add one more position. Once we add the positions, you can also calculate your animation. This will be based on the position which I have saved. So you can also save this animation as an AVI file. This will be very helpful for data collaboration. And also we can use this for our motion study. We are having our mate controller over to the animation wizard. So by having this new enhancement mate controller, now we can easily collaborate our design with our vendors or suppliers. Now let us move on to eDrawing. As everyone knows, eDrawing is a powerful tool for data collaboration. Now eDrawing 2016, we are having a lot of enhancement. Like now we are having a multi-tabbed documents. And now eDrawing 2016, it will support for weld features. Now let us have a look. Here you can see this multiple tab in eDrawing. Now eDrawing 2016 will support for 3D views at any time. You can see the different views. Here in 2016, introduce the new capability, exploded views, either radially or linear, both the things. Now you can see your component definition. Here you can see the weld. So weld, so directly you can see your weld details over here. So you can see your component definition simply by selecting show component description. You can see the different component description directly over here. So these are some of the enhancement in eDrawing 2016 which will very much helpful for our data collaboration. So all the enhancement under collaborate is mainly helpful for streamline our design process. Now let us move on to the next category, build drawing. So creating and detailing is very, very much easier in drawing. Now SOLIDWORKS 2016 take things to the next level. As everyone knows, flag notes is very much helpful for documenting our design intent. Now we can easily define our flag notes. Now we are having a new enhancement, flag note bank. And also we can define the border. Once we set the flag note, we can easily add a balloon. And we can easily specify our flag note. Here I am adding my flag note. Simply, we are placing the mouse over the flag note, we will get the text we have added. Now it's very easy to attach or detach our stack balloon at any time. At any time we can attach or detach, and also we can include our flag notes to the stack balloon. We can also reorder the stack balloon based on alphabetically or numerically. Now it's very easy to scale our sheet size directly from the status bar. Another enhancement in 2016 is, while adding dimension, the first selection remain valid even though if you place your cursor over the blank space. This will save our time. Now it's very easy to move our text. We can place our text wherever we want. Creating and editing of the drawing border is always been a manual process. Now SOLIDWORKS 2016 introduced the new enhancement called automatic border. By having this new enhancement, we can easily create our drawing border in our drawing. I'm editing my sheet format, and also we can directly go to edit sheet format directly over here. For better clarity, I am hiding my title block. So I am deleting the drawing border. So by having this new enhancement, automatic border, we can easily create our drawing border, and also we can define our zone size and margin by specifying the values over here. And also we introduce new enhancement called margin mask. If you want to hide anything in the border, like AB, like onto, if you want to hide anything, just you move the mask over to the text and alphabets. This will hide the thing. Now we can see the changes. Another powerful enhancement in 2016 is the performance evaluation. This will helpful for find out our rebuild time and also the different warnings. It will give available feedback. So these are some of the enhancements in our drawing, which will be very much helpful for make our detailing in a very easier manner. So all the enhancement under build is mainly built up for our design, fast track our design to manufacturing. The remaining enhancement in SOLIDWORKS, Mr. Venkatesh will take care of it. Thank you.